Recently, I've seen the left make a concerted effort to consolidate all authority, all jurisdiction, and all ability to speak into any issue of our life at the national level, almost as if Mr. Biden wants to be our father, so to speak. And unfortunately, I have seen the Republican Party not speak against that growth of national jurisdiction. Do you see that as a concern?
Well, this is a problem that's been dating back to at least the time since I've been paying attention to politics, even before I could vote. That would be in the Reagan era. And, you know, President Reagan talked about eliminating the Department of Education, and you know, that didn't happen. Today, I think just yesterday, I saw a Republican senator introduce a bill to sort of nationalize the concept of money following the students. You know, historically, Republicans have always been in favor of local control as much as possible of everything. And, you know, much as I agree with the concept and would vote for it locally, I don't think the federal government has anything to do with that. And I think that the federal government doesn't have anything to do with many things. I don't think Asians should be beaten in the streets or anybody, but I don't think that frankly, the federal government constitutionally has jurisdiction over so-called anti-Asian hate crime violence. You know, hate, the concept of a hate crime itself is anathema to any serious scholar of the First Amendment. Yes. It's you know, sort of getting into somebody's head. It's Clockwork Orange type of stuff. I mean, how do we get into people's heads? We should be punishing people's actions and not their thoughts. And so yet Republicans happily have ceded that and are just playing along. And particularly irresponsible is when you know you don't have a majority and can't pass the bill, just introducing show legislation for clicks and for fundraising purposes, I think is irresponsible and, you know, really craven, frankly. Yeah.